Our fields of perception are Buddha fields. The spaciousness that is pristine spontaneity pervades everything, joining outside and inside. It has no boundaries, top or bottom, and is beyond direction. As pure presence, it is clear like the sky, non-spatial, non-dual, as the vast matrix itself. It is beyond pulsating thought and image. The magical illusion that emanates within this unborn spaciousness, quite indeterminate, without any definition whatsoever, cannot be denominated as something, for it has no substance or attribute. Insofar as its sky-like nature fills space-time, it is unborn spontaneity, no before or after, no beginning or end. The nature of all samsara and nirvana is this luminous mind, unmanifest, unproduced, indeterminate spontaneity, coming from nowhere and going nowhere. The matrix of luminous mind indicates neither past nor future, for it is unvarying in its all-pervasive uniformity. Reality, just as it is, without beginning, middle, or end, an all-pervasive smoothness, it is sky-like in nature. Without either beginning or end, it supersedes linear time. Without origination or cessation, it can have neither substance nor attribute. It is invariable, so it cannot be denominated as anything. It cannot be induced or practiced, so nothing is to be done. And without mass or volume, it is the ground of suchness. Unimaginable and unassailable, it is the matrix of sameness. Since sameness is the reality of all things, everything necessarily rests in the matrix of sameness. This luminous mind is a singularity in which all is equal. And since its all-pervasive smoothness is like unmanifest space, within that gamut of sameness, there can be no intervention. This fortress of non-temporal spontaneity, all-pervasive, this fortress of the vast matrix of the now, without top, bottom, or middle, this fortress of the unborn Dharmakaya, impartially all-accommodating, this fortress of the precious secret that is unchanging spontaneity, this fortress of the now, the entire galaxy, samsara and nirvana, this is the totality, the single denominator. Upon a zero-dimensional, all-pervasive foundation stands the palace of luminous mind, samsara and nirvana identical. At its marvelously high pinnacle is the vast matrix of reality, the center of an uncreated omnidimensional panorama, a wide-open doorway to freedom from graduated endeavor. Within that palace, arrayed with spontaneously amassed wealth, the king, self-sprung awareness, takes his throne. His pulsating projections, emanations of his pristine awareness, serve as ministers who govern his domain. The holy queen, innate meditative absorption, attends. With spontaneous guru vision, her offspring and her servants, all centered in the pure pleasure matrix of intrinsic non-conceptual clarity. Within that still, ineffable plenum, the king masters all manifest and potential appearances, and the immense dominion of vast spaciousness is his. Living in that land, everything is Dharmakaya, never straying from our unitary self-sprung awareness in the now, seizing the uncreated now beyond striving and practice, encompassed by one soul sphere that has no hard edges, Just as we are centered in that undifferentiated, all-inclusive matrix. Since the six mythic realms and even the Buddha fields shine nowhere but in that sky-like reality, in that inherently clear, luminous mind, they are of one taste. And samsara and nirvana are naturally assimilated to pure presence. In this treasury of existential spaciousness, the universal source, nirvana unsought, is the constant spontaneity of the now. So given the Dharmakaya as unchanging, non-referential, all-investing, internal and external visions, all life forms are the Sambhogakaya. And the Nirmanakaya is like naturally occurring reflection. So all experience necessarily ornamenting the three kayas, it is all empty physical, energetic, and mental display. And the countless Buddha fields, likewise, without exception, all arise from the same source, with nature of mind, the Trikaya matrix. The contents of samsara, the six realms and their inhabitants, also surely are mere reflections within intrinsic spaciousness. All the phantasmagoria of life and death, pleasure and pain, like apparitional show, abound in the matrix of mind in itself, apparent, yet insubstantial, and hence truly non-existent. It occurs through adventitious circumstance, like moisture condensing as clouds, neither existent nor non-existent, beyond determinate extremes. It is all included in the one soul sphere where nothing is elaborated. The nature of mind, the essential luminous mind, pure like the sky, free of birth and death, pleasure and pain, unaffected by materiality, is indifferent to samsara and nirvana. It cannot be indicated as something, for it is a vast sky-like matrix, unchanging and incapable of sublimation. It is unalloyed spontaneity. Buddha lies in the Vajra heart, that is clear light, where everything is fields of self-sprung bliss, everything the unremitting sameness of that supreme light. Canto 2, Buddhafields, from Longchenpa, translated by Keith Dauman in the book Spaciousness, the Radical Dzogchen Vajra Heart. All right, very great. That's it.